Engineering. I'm Alan. Firstly, I apologise for my voice, I have a cold. Today, we'll be looking at some new tooling and I'll do some machining on the milling machine. One of the tools we'll be looking at is this. It's listed as a boring bar come end mill. It's 150mm long. It has two inserts on the end and it will give you a 14mm diameter hole. But we'll see how that performs on the lathe. I'll also test this. It's classed as a chamfering, grooving or centering tool. It's an insert set at 60 degrees, I think it is, with the tip being in the centre. I have a set of these carbide end mills. They go from 12mm down to 2mm. And I'll use a 12mm one on the milling machine to make a new block to indicate where the table position is. So let's go to the workshop, see how we do it. Just want to show you this set of end mills. They're carbide end mills. This one starts at 12mm. This is a 10, an 8, a 6, a 5, a 4, a 3, and the small one is a 2mm. And I'll put the link at the beginning of the video. I also had this end mill. 150 long, it's quite a long end mill, and it's 14mm diameter. Well, I thought this might make a good boring bar as well. You could take one of the tips off and you've got yourself a boring bar. This part's listed as a boring bar or milling cutter. It comes with a set of 10 inserts and the key for tightening them up. I think this is a bit too long to use as an end mill at over 150mm long, but I think it'll make an ideal boring bar for the lathe, so I'll try that on the lathe a little later. And the last tool for today is this one. It's a 60 degree angle tip and the diameter is 16mm. It's used for cutting grooves, chamfers, or centering. It doesn't come with any inserts, but I have bought some inserts and you get those in a pack of 10. It comes with the key to tighten the inserts, and I'm going to try this in the lathe to see how well it will cut a chamfer. So let's take the 12mm end mill, which is a carbide, use that on the milling machine and cut some metal. I think I need to speed a bit faster, so I'll take it up to 1000, see if I can improve the finish.
For some reason, it seems to give a better finish when cutting from left to right than it does cutting from right to left. This is the tool I use to engrave. It's a piece of carbide steel that's been ground halfway through. And then all they do is put a taper on the end and a flat which creates a cutting edge. And you can get these with a point on or a flat on, and the wider the flat, the wider the mark is that you engrave. I usually run these on the CNC machine, and they're usually between 19 and 20,000 RPM. Now I've put an engraving cutter into the collet, and I've put the speed up to 1,600. Just scribed a line down the centre. The way I set it up on these cutters, half the cutter's been machined away. It's a flat on one side and just a point. Let's see if I can take that out. It was use the flat to come up against the edge so I know it's on centre, and then just wind it in the correct amount. Now unfortunately I can't use my edge finder with the light in, because the ball on this will not fit low enough into the jaw to get the edge of this aluminium. So what I'm using is the bearing. Wind it in until it touches. Zero the slide, get the centre, I'm just going to use the back of the vise. Avoid it in until touches. Now, once I've got the position of the jaw, I know the diameter of the bearing, I know the width of the jaw, and I know the centre line distance. So by adding all those in and moving the cutter across, I get the centre of the part. Centre on there, and then move it in. take the fraise off that on each side, that's finished. And what I've done on the line here is used a Sharpie felt tip to draw a black line, and then I've just polished it with some emery to so that the black part stays there. Just in case you're wondering what I'm making, it's just a little block with a position line on that shows me the position of the table. That's left a nice finish on the chamfer. If this was set at a 30 degree angle, it would give a nice finish for a centre to locate in. Especially if you've got a damaged centre, you could trim it up with this. I've noticed that in the past, if you use a centre with multi-cutting faces, and you try to true a centre up, you'll end up putting chatter marks on the surface of the diameter. But when used in a single cutting edge, that shouldn't happen. I think this will be a future tool to make. This type of tool with the tip set at 30 degrees for making centres, restoring centres. I fitted the end mill with the inserts into my tool holder, lined it up, and I just want to see how it will bore a hole if it was used as a boring bar. Let's cut the material easy. I think the finish will improve if I use the traverse on the feed. I think it cuts the part better than a boring bar would do. So once you use this tool, if you use it as a drill, you can open up an existing hole. Let's try doing a cut with the traverse. See the finish on there, it's very good. So that would make a good boring bar.
Oh well, that's it for today. Hope some of that was interesting. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.